Welcome back to the Mr. Excel Netcast. I'm Bill Jelen. Today is an interesting charting tip. Right here I have a chart that attempts to compare our company to four other companies. And so there's five different time series showing data from 2001 to 2007. And really, when you try and put five time series on one single chart, it just becomes confusing. No one can look at this and really figure out exactly what's going on. So a cool tip is to take that one chart and replace it with four smaller charts. Basically, in every chart, we're comparing our company versus one of the competitors. And really, that's what people want to see. They want to see how we're doing versus each competitor. So now we can see, you know, our company versus other guys. Other guys are just going up and down, and we're smooth versus this new company. The new company's coming along. They're about the same size as we are. The mega company, the company that had market share, is falling off, and we've actually beaten them. And then versus some other company, we're kind of trending along. So people can now look at this and see exactly how we're doing against each competitor. And because there's only two lines on each chart, they can actually get a feeling for what's going on rather than just having a mess with the five charts on the one sheet. The other thing I've done is I've made each chart smaller, about 1/4 the size that it used to be. So this fits in the exact same spot, for example, on an executive dashboard as the one big chart, but it is so much more useful to break that data up into four charts. The next time you're trying to show a whole bunch of information on one single chart, think about breaking it up into several different charts, and each chart can be smaller but have a detailed bit of information. Hey, thanks for stopping by. We'll see you next time for another Netcast from Mr. Excel.